رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Oh my Lord, open my heart, easy my tasks, and remove the impediments from my speech, so that they may understand what I say. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are going to do another video, and today I'm going to recite Surah Al-Qadr, and I'm going to tell the meanings of it. I'm also going to tell a few things what happened in Laylatul Qadr. And then my sister is going to recite Surah Al-Kafirun and Surah Nas. Isra, do you know anything about Laylatul Qadr? You know Surah Qadr? Okay, first I'm going to tell Surah Qadr and then I'm going to tell the meaning of it, okay? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. Now Ishraat, I'm going to tell the meanings of it, okay?
Okay.
So, verse number one. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr. This means, indeed we revealed the Quran on the night of Al-Qadr. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down the entire Quran from the Lawhil Mahfuz to the first heaven, and then Jibreel took the Quran little by little down to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam over 23 years. Understood? You know the Quran?
Yeah.
And so, Laylatul Qadr is a day in the Quran. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the Quran in that day. And then, you know heaven, yeah? Jannah. So he has sent the Quran from the Lawhil Mahfuz to Jannah. And then Jibreel alayhi salam, which is the angel, took the Quran little by little to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam over 23 years. It took 23 years for Jibreel alayhi salam to take the Quran little by little to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Okay? So you know what Lawhil Mahfuz is? Okay. Lawhil Mahfuz is a book in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote everything, okay? So now, everything that will happen. It's a book in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote everything that will happen. Okay? So now I'm going to say the verse 2. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. This means, and what will make you know what the night of Qadr is. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us, do we know what Laylatul Qadr is? Okay? And then the verse 3 is Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. The night of Al-Qadr is better than 1,000 months of worship. You know I said that in the verse 2, yeah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us, do we know what Laylatul Qadr is? And in the verse 3, they're telling it the answer. Laylatul Qadr is Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. If you compare one Laylatul Qadr with 1,000 months, it's still better than 1,000 months, okay? So, what does 1,000 months say? 83 years, 4 months and 4 months, okay? 83 years and 4 months. Or you can also say 83 years and 30,000 nights. You know, nights. So, and now I'm going to tell The world's full, okay?
تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر.
This is the verse 4. I'm also going to tell the verse 5. Verse 4 and 5.
سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر.
So the two verses means the angels and Jibreel descend. The angels and Jibreel descend in it by the permission of their Lord for every decree. This is the meaning of verse 4, and then the verse 5 is be still, it is the break of dawn. The everything joined up together, it means that angels come down in huge numbers with a ruh. You know what a ruh is? Angel Jibreel. So a ruh means angel Jibreel. So angel Jibreel and other angels bring down peace and blessings until its fajr. So Ar-Ruh, the angel Jibreel, and the other angels bring down the peace and blessings upon us until its fajr. You know what fajr is? Okay, good job. So in this night of power, if you recite Quran, you know what will happen? The angels will surround you, and then they're going to do the zikr of Allah. And then, you know, angels have wings. Everyone knows angels have wings. So they're going to lower their wings. They're going to lower their wings with peace and respect upon us. Okay? And then I'm going to tell another interesting thing. So it also means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above the seventh heaven, okay? So the things which you can see in the sky, like the stars and the sun and the moon, the solar system, everything is in the first heaven. So in the lower third of the night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to the first heaven. You know what lower third of the night is? Like in the lower third of Laylatul Qadr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to come down to the first heaven, and then he's going to tell, I am the king. Who he has any dua that I can accept? Who he has any need that I can fulfill? Okay? Until the break of dawn. So, any questions still that much? Okay. So, now I'm going to tell the sixth one. So now I'm going to tell a small story based on Laylatul Qadr. So one day Aisha radiallahu anha, you know who she is?
She's Prophet Muhammad's wife.
Yeah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's wife. You got it right. Okay, so one day Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what shall I make dua for if I witness the night, means the Laylatul Qadr. So, radiallahu anha is asking Prophet Muhammad, what dua should she make for witnessing the night, which is Laylatul Qadr. So the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Okay. I want you to repeat after me. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. Okay, this dua means, O Allah, you are al-afuun, the pardoner, and you love to pardon, so pardon. Okay? In this dua, we call Allah by the name al-afuun. So, let me explain what really al-afu is. Example, a person did three sins. First thing, that person told a lie. Second thing, that person Okay, the person didn't listen to his parents, or the person didn't pray. Okay, so first thing, the person told lies. Second thing, the person didn't pray. And the third thing, the person had a fight with his or her friends. Okay. So if that person says, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase all of his sins, and then no one will ever notice that he actually did those sins, okay? You know what sins means? Guna. Like something bad. So now I'm going to tell you something interesting, which you will hopefully like it. So, here. Another important thing that will happen in the night of Qadr is Fay or Qadr, okay? Means what we'll do in the future. So, well is what we'll do in the future. It is determined in this night, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ad-Dukhan, verse number 4. Fiha ufarriku kullu amrin hakeem. Okay? Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will determine our future. And so he says this in Surah 4, verse number 4. Fiha
ufarriku
kullu amrin hakeem. Okay, so did you like the whole thing? Did you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me something which you want to tell about the Laylatul Qadr? You can tell anything. What you understood.
Jibril took the Quran little by little to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
For 23 years. Okay, good. What is Lawh al-Mahfuz?
It's a book that Allah writes all the things.
What will happen? Wow, you did great. Ishra, can you recite Surah Al-Kafirun? Okay, recite.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qul ya ayyuhal kafirun, la a'budu ma ta'budun, wa la antum a'biduna ma a'bud, wa la لكم دينكم ولي دين صدق الله العظيم.
Wow, that was a really nice recitation of Surah Al-Kafirun. Now can you recite Surah An-Nas?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس صدق الله العظيم.
That was also a beautiful recitation of Surah An-Nas. Okay, you did really good, really great job today, and I'm really happy you revised everything. So, thank you for watching our video. Hope you liked it, and Please like, share and follow.